Hello, everybody. Welcome to Morning English. This is Blair.
Hi, guys. This is Summer. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
前段时间我们才讲了韩国的医疗罢工、那现在在美国呢是孕妇啊都不敢生小孩了。
哎，对，是因为那个堕胎合法被推翻了、对吧？22年的时候啊，罗素韦德案呢被推翻，女性的堕胎权不再受到宪法保护了。
对，所以呢有的医院急诊室呢就直接拒收孕妇。Cases listed in federal documents raise alarms around emergency pregnancy care, especially in states with strict abortion laws.
对，这里有个关键词啊 ,abortion, 就是堕胎的意思。尤其是呢在美国有的州啊，它的堕胎法是非常严的 ,with strict abortion laws. 孕妇的处境就更加难了。You know, one woman miscarried in the restroom lobby of a Texas emergency room as from desk staff refused to admit her to the hospital.
这名孕妇呢就在急救中心，但是医院不收、但是后来就直接流产了。那这都是真实案件啊，也特别让人心痛，就是这种拒收的案例。
对，而且类似这种案例还真不少啊。So in today's show, let's get deeper into that and learn some related expressions.
OK, 那我们今天呢就来和大家一起聊聊在美国生小孩这件事儿。
OK, 那在这里啊孕妇被拒收呢应用到这个表达 turn away. Pregnant women were turned away from US emergency rooms.
对，我们知道 turn down 啊表示拒绝、那这里的 turn away 啊就是表示拒绝进入一个地方。To refuse to allow someone to enter a place. 比如说座位都满了啊其他人都不让进去。All the seats were sold and a large crowd had to be turned away.
对。还有像收容所呢它不会拒绝那些有需要的人进去啊。The homeless shelter will not turn away people in need. 那你看医院本来就是治病啊救命的地方现在呢却眼睁睁的看着孕妇和小孩的生命呢在眼前消失啊。
The cases raise alarms about the state of emergency pregnancy care, especially in states that enacted strict abortion laws and sparked confusion around the treatment doctors can legally provide.
对，像其他州的一些 OB 啊，也就是产科医生、obstetrician, 看到这个事件呢，他们就评论说 It is shocking. It is absolutely shocking. It's appalling that someone would show up to an emergency room and not receive care.、This is inconceivable. 这件事情是非常的 shocking, appalling, 就是让人震惊啊。急救室不抢救人，这简直就是 inconceivable, 是难以想象的，都不敢相信。
对 ,inconceivable, 同义词是 unthinkable,、meaning impossible to imagine or believe. 比如说、令人难以置信的是大家竟然都没有意识到这个问题。It is inconceivable that people were not aware of the problem.
对。那多名孕妇呢被医院拒收的事件也持续发酵。在美国呢急救室拒收病人其实也是违规的、
那肯定了。
Federal law requires emergency rooms to treat or stabilize patients who are in active labor and provide a medical transfer to another hospital if they don't have the staff or resources to treat them.
对这就是联邦法律的规定。Emergency rooms need to treat or stabilize patients. Treat, 就是我们说的治疗Stabilize 就表示需要稳定患者的病情。
对，这个 stable 是稳定的这个形容词，动词呢就是 stabilize。比如说，患者的病情稳定了下来 ，the patient's condition stabilized。所以你看，既然违规，那就要有处罚啊。现在情况呢，就是拜登政府啊，对十几家没能妥善治疗孕妇的医院呢，进行起诉和处罚。
对，原告就是这个拜登政府，被告呢，就是爱达荷州的堕胎禁令。The Biden administration has sued Idaho over its abortion ban, even in medical emergencies, arguing it conflicts with the federal law.
Yeah.No woman should be denied the care she needs.
Yeah.
All patients, including women who are experiencing pregnancy-related emergencies, should have access to emergency medical care.要生小孩了啊这个急救室还不接诊这谁还敢生小孩呢
对于一些急救室来说孕妇呢就好像自带辐射了一样啊。Pregnant patients have become radioactive to emergency departments in states with extreme abortion restrictions. They are so scared of a pregnant patient that the emergency medicine staff won't even look. They just want these people gone.
对。而且其实拒收病人呢这个医院也是会面临巨额的罚款。 emergency rooms are subject to hefty fines when they turn away patients, fail to stabilize them, or transfer them to another hospital for treatment.
对，那这里的罚款就是这个词 fine 啊，巨额的，用到了这个形容词 hefty,、mm-hmm. meaning larger than usual or expected. 然后还有一个非常常见的搭配啊，就是一笔非常可观的利润，我们可以说 make a hefty profit.
对。但是呢，一般这种情况，这个罚款得要很多年才能征收到啊。It can take years for fines to be levied in these cases. 那这里的收到征收用的是这个词啊 ,levy.
对。那现在双方呢也是争论不休、嗯、一方因为严苛的堕胎令不敢收孕妇，一方呢在争取所有患者接受同等治疗的权利。那这句话我觉得说得很到位啊。
嗯、
Doctors, not politicians, should determine what constitutes emergency care.
对。决定患者是不是该接受紧急医疗护理的，应该是医生而不是政客啊。
Yeah.
这里的关键词就是 constitute, 是个很正式的表达，意思就是被算作或者是组成构成。比如说 what constitutes emergency care, 就是表示什么能被算作紧急医疗护理。
Yeah, it means to be considered to be something. 比如说现在这种紧张状态的升级啊，就是对社会的一种威胁。The increase in tension constitutes a threat to our society.
对。但是以美国现在的情况来看呢，实现这一点并不容易啊。
Yeah.
OK, 那我们今天话题大家有什么看法吗？也欢迎给我们留言呀。And that's all we have for today.
那今天的节目就到这里了。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
So thank you so much for listening. This is Summer.
And this is Blair. See you next time.
Bye.